Mark, so did you want to say something real quick?
No, you go ahead. You got okay. The great interview.
Okay. All right, you guys. So he is the up-and-coming MMA and illegitimate son of a televangelist on Fox's new show, Filthy Rich. But it's also his very first role ever. Please welcome Benjamin Levy Aguilar. Good morning, Benjamin. Thank you. By the way, thank you for stretching with us.
Thank you for having me stretch. You know, it's something that with my martial arts, I should really encourage people to do.
Oh my gosh, we're going to talk all about your martial arts in a second, but you know, you're an outstanding athlete. I didn't realize, I did all kinds of research on you last night, and I there's so many things to talk about, but at one point you actually considered being a professional soccer player, right?
Yes, that soccer was my first dream. You know, I think that growing up in Guatemala, it's a country that just everything revolves around soccer, or football, like we call it, you know, and like you see any commercial on TV, even if it's a toothpaste commercial, it's going to have to do with soccer, you know? So it's like a part of the culture. And I believe that it really gave me a right path when I was little. It kept me sane and healthy.
Yeah, you said it got you through a lot of things. And then I guess you had an injury, a pretty serious injury. You kind of realized you weren't destined to be an athlete anymore. And I read that you were at this crossroads when you and your mom are at the DMV of all places, and you kind of had a revelation. Can you tell me about that?
Yes. Oh my God. So after I played soccer, I did self-defense and martial arts, and I became a black belt in Krav Maga. I worked for the Israeli embassy and the Guatemalan government, and I was going to go to Israel. And, but I, you know, something wasn't right. I wanted something more, you know, I wanted something more. And I felt like, you know, what happened to soccer? What happened to like having such a big dream to chase, you know? And my mom just like, it was the first time we ever talked about it. She was like, hey, what about acting? And I remember thinking like, oh, like, yeah, like movies. Like, yeah, okay, what do you mean? Like, what? Like, she's like, yeah, you know, like Brad Pitt, he's like in the movie. So maybe you could just do that. And it was like the first time that I thought that was an actual possibility, that was a career. And I was like, all right, how do you do that? And she said, you know, I guess you go to Hollywood, right? And I was like, yeah. I was like, okay, cool. Yeah, okay, well, that sounds exciting, you know? Like, and I just needed some sort of excitement. So I was like, let's do it. So we called the airline that same, like, we were in traffic going to the DMV. Yeah, and we called the airline, and we booked the flight for the next week.
That day. And then you get, this is your first role ever, a huge role it is. How did you get the role? How did you find out about it? Tell me about that.
Well, you know, I had done a short film prior about an MMA fighter cutting weight, and I lost like 30 pounds for that role. And it was like a small short film that, you know, that I met incredible people at. And from there, I got my manager, and my manager signed me right before pilot season. He was like, are you ready for your first pilot season? And I was like, yeah. And Filthy Rich came in like 2 weeks later.
Wow.
And yeah, so it was my first callback. It was my first screen test. I didn't know what a screen test was. It was my first in a lot of things.
You're doing so great on the show. I want to show everybody what we're talking about. Again, this is Filthy Rich with Benjamin and Kim Cattrall in her first kind of big network role since Sex and the City. Take a look.
I've never seen this much food.
I always say, cook as much as you need and then double it. There's nothing more shameful than having just enough.
Well, I grew up mostly on rice and beans and cornflakes.
I won't let you go hungry, baby. Food is love, and I've got plenty of both.
Oh my gosh. I mean, I love the role. It's really campy. It's great. The show looks amazing. Now, you've been kind of touching on this throughout the interview. You're obviously very fit. You do Krav Maga. You post some of your workouts. Krav Maga is like an Israeli-based style of martial arts, right? So tell me about some of the things you learned, like tactical shooting, defensive driving. By the way, does that help in LA traffic?
It does. Oh, absolutely. But especially Guatemalan traffic. But yes, you know, Krav Maga is a self-defense it's not about a trophy at the end. It's about saving your life. You know, that's the trophy. So there's no rules, and it's about inflicting the most amount of damage in the least time with the minimum risk for yourself. So it's a very aggressive self-defense aspect, because at the moment that your life is at risk, you have to go all in, right? So we talk about the fight or flight situation. And then once you get deeper in, like when I did with the Israeli embassy and with the government, you start learning defensive driving, tactical shooting, how to shoot outside from vehicles to ongoing, you know, vehicles, or how to get out of a vehicle, or how to, you know, do whatever you need to do to, you know, and a lot of logistics as well. Like it is, does encompass so many different styles and things. And the beauty of Krav Maga is that it grabs everything from anything that works, they just compile it together. It's like the original mixed martial arts, really.
Benjamin, you are a fascinating guy, and I'm so glad we got to talk to you this morning. Did you have something you wanted to ask?
Okay, so he's got there's a curtain behind it. It's crooked.
Okay, so Benjamin, Mark wants you to fix the curtain behind you. It's crooked.
No, there has to be someone at home who says there's a crooked curtain.
Yeah.
You can't have a curtain
he's
without...
He's like, what are you talking about?
That actually just happened. That actually just happened, and I was like,
it's a morning,
really?
Let's have fix it?
Can we... Yeah, can you fix it right now? Because it's going to bug him.
Oh, my God.
Can you do it right now?
I can't fix it because, like, I actually, like, broke the thing, and now I have to, like,
find a way to... Were you doing pull-ups on the curtain rod?
You literally, like, read my mind right now, because I was like, oh, my God, like, they're going to be looking at that. You're going to be looking at that, because I was looking at it from the back. Embarrassing.
Oh, it's not embarrassing.
You fit right in the best, Benjamin. No. You fit right in. Benjamin, will you come back and teach us some Krav Maga?
Oh my God!
I would love to. Absolutely, yes.
You should. Yeah, when we can do contact stuff, we'll have you come on and teach us Krav Maga. Benjamin, we love you. You're such a good sport.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. You guys can catch new episodes of Filthy Rich every Monday night on Fox at 9 p.m. However, by the way, due to the Kansas City Chiefs and the Buffalo Bills game tomorrow, Filthy Rich is going to start a little bit later at 9:15. Benjamin, thank you. Love you. Have a great weekend.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Bye. Thank you, Beck.